I'm not working today. So since they're having IT issues, I guess I get cute, do some TikToks, and order me some Panera.
So that's a spider, y'all. It's a big-ass spider. I thought spiders hid in the daytime. Why is this big motherfucker still out here?
Sorry for the angle, y'all. It's the best I could do. Don't mind none of this. But I'm about to put on my lashes real quick and some gloss. Y'all saw that big old spider, right? In the earlier clip. Okay, little tea. I went to go see because the sun came out. Because I thought that spiders didn't come out in the daytime. Correction. They can come out in the daytime if it's gloomy enough and humid enough. So, I just went to go check to see if, yes, I named her. Her name's Victoria, Charlotte's sister. I went to go check to see if she went in. So, basically, her web is right there. Her prey is wrapped around in her web. And she's tucked, like, up on the roof of the little, because we got a little stoop or whatever. And there's, like, a little, you know, little roof on top of there or whatever, and she's like tucked on top of the column hiding from the sun. They don't like sunlight. Still there, but she's not like hanging in her web right now. So technically, indirectly, I got a pet spider. Pretty sure she's poisonous because she's orange and brown. I'm pretty sure she's a brown recluse, but I ain't going nowhere near her. And honestly, as long as you don't fuck with them, they will not fuck with you. I just don't want her to get in here because then I'm going to have to hurt her. But she's that type of spider. I don't necessarily know how it would get in somebody's house unless it got on somebody's clothes or bags or something like that. Because she's nowhere near, nowhere near an opening. Like, she ain't by the door. She's, like, out. Like, so if she falls, she going to fall in the grass type shit. You know what I'm saying? But, she a big ass spider. I don't like spiders, but Charlotte's Web is one of my favorite movies. When I was a kid, it was one of my favorite movies. It was a very sad movie, but it was one of my favorite movies. I had Panera earlier today, but I killed that. My favorite Panera is the Chipotle chicken with the avocado. Love that. And then I got me some tea. So y'all know I work at a call center. I've been working in call centers for a minute. Before that, I was working in retail. I don't like call centers. Call centers and retail are right here with me. I don't mind working with the public, but I like working with the public at my own pace. And call centers is just, I'm over being at a call center. Like, I don't even think it would matter if I went back to the building at this point. I'm just over being at a call center. Like, I feel like people when they see you in person, they still talk crazy to you, but it's at a limit. When you at a call center, people will talk cash shit to you. They are really over the phone, cyber bullies. And they will talk cash shit to you. This lady called me a dummy, and I've been called worse. So I wasn't tripping. It was just the fact that I wasn't being rude or anything. I honestly just couldn't hear her. And she called me a dummy. Boy. Now, I know what you only what somebody, you know, what you are only what you answer to. I think that's how it goes. Yes, you are only what you answer to. And I know I'm not a dummy. So I didn't say shit. She ain't talking to me. And I continue to try to help her. But when I tell you, I just really came to the realization, like, bitch, you are good at customer service. It is definitely an easy job for you to do, and it is very obtainable, but it is not your purpose. It is not what you are meant to do for life. And granted, it's a temporary situation, but it's been a little temporary for a little bit too long, about 3-4 years too long, because I've been working in customer service in person and at a call center for over 5 years, like 5+ years. No. I want to go back to school in the spring to get my master's next year. It may not be the spring. It may be like summer, fall semester, but I definitely want to get in some master's program because I can. And find me a better job. So Gina's going to try to get me on at the hospital, at least like something clerical, so that I don't have to deal with it. I don't mind doing paperwork. I don't mind helping people in the office. I don't mind helping people in person fill out information or chart information or enter data. You know what I'm saying? I have no problems with that. But I can't. I almost cussed an 80-some-year-old woman out yesterday for calling me a dummy. And I was like, I'm not going to do it. But damn it, I was close. So I'm working on my purpose. I'm manifesting in my journal. I'm really trying to think of what I need to do for me. I've had really high anxiety here lately. And I'm just trying to make sure that I keep my sanity and my health in line and grounded, pretty much. But other than that, life is great. I feel good. I'm doing good. Everything's smooth. You know, normal life shenanigans. You know, you deal with the punches, whatever. Nothing major. Gina's uncle is doing better, FYI. Yes, I wanted to let y'all know an update on that from the last vlog. But other than that, like, I'm just trying to make it day to day, y'all. So I hope all of y'all are doing well. I hope y'all having a good week. I hope y'all have a great weekend coming up. And I hope y'all stick around here on the channel. Who knows? You know, I'm just thankful to wake up every day and get to experience life every day, take a breath every day, you know. So I can't really complain, because I know there's people out there that have it way worse than me, especially with everything that has gone down. So I try not to complain and get down, because I know it could be worse. But I'm still a human. I still have feelings. It still gets to me a little bit. Don't get me wrong, the bullshit, completely unbothered by. I could care less. But when it comes to my sanity and my health, I don't play. Or the sanity and health of my family, I don't play. So yeah, I just wanted to chit chat with y'all a little bit. Kind of let y'all know where we at with it. I was supposed to be smoking this blunt. I lit it, but I never hit it. Probably need to take a cleanse from this, to be honest. I'm trying to go like 3 or 4 days without smoking. Y'all know it's been like over 5 months since I quit smoking cigarettes. So proud of me. I quit in March. So April, May, June, July, August. It's been 6 months, correction. So been doing really, really well with not smoking cigarettes or any other type of tobacco besides Arello, which I gut anyway. But yeah. I try to take a few days away from the cannabis just because my anxiety has been so high that I don't want to, you know, tweak. Because I'm really bad at doing that sometimes, especially if I'm already, like, amped up. But I'm about to put on some fake lashes. These are by Slicker Accessories on Instagram. I love her lashes because they're affordable. They got cute little names and they're bomb. And this is Rich Dick. And they're really dramatic. You can see them. So I'm about to throw these on using the Duo Brush On Adhesive with Vitamins. Ooh, they fancy. So this is my new lash glue. I really, really like it. I like the liner with the glue in it, but it's hard to get off. I don't know what the fuck that is. But I really, really like this glue. So this is my alternative to that. I'm not putting no liner on because they're not going to be on that long. And I'm not putting no other makeup on. And then I got this new lip plumper from Ulta. a little while ago. It's by Essence, and it's What the Fake. It's a lip plumping gauze. It's really cute, shimmery, and clear. And I'm into this new thing where I like to darken my top lip with Max Chestnut. Super cute little lip. And chill for the day. Let me go check in on my computer real quick. And I will see you guys in later weekend vlog content. But I just wanted to chit chat with y'all today. Start the vlog since I had time. In case, you know, we don't do too much. I know Gina has to get her hair done tomorrow. She got to go get tires on Saturday. So I don't know. We may go out for drinks, something fun, something. I'm going to try. Otherwise, this was just a little you and me time. Okay?
Did you keep my name out your mouth?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
What are
seven,
you doing?
8. I'm trying to play hide go seek so I can go find who the fuck you talking to.
So, yeah, y'all. It is almost 3 o'clock. I haven't been on the phones at all today. I still can't log in. They keep, like, changing and modifying my schedule. As long as they're not stating that I was a no-call, no-show, I really don't give a fuck. It better say technical, because that's exactly what the fuck is going on. And they haven't gave me a callback. IT hasn't given me a callback, so... Yes, Sage. I feel really good. I saged, I showered, and I'm chilling. At Nadia's, they had to get some stuff. Bae's trying to dye her hair, y'all. Yeah. Probably this color.
Really?
Yeah.
But brighter?
Yeah.
You think I should get?
Get both.
She trying to manipulate me. But it ain't gonna work. Yeah, it ain't gonna work.
They be judging me because I like my little African shows and movies. These go hard though, y'all. I promise y'all. They better than some American independent films. These are the shit. So, this is how I'm spending my off day again. And I ain't complaining. Not at all. He an asshole.
Hey, y'all. So, I didn't work again today. No. But I'm about to submit my timesheet because it's not my fault. Run me my coins. I'm going to submit my timesheet as usual, per usual. I was reminded by my agency to do so. So I'm going to do that. My homie had came over early and brought me my cookies ashtray. Her sister owns a smoke shop and I try to support, especially black-owned businesses. So since I got the purple cookies grinder last time, I went ahead and had her bring me the tray. Right now it's just for show, but it'll probably get used. And y'all know I had got my cookies tray from another smoke shop a while ago, so yeah. Shoot this shit with my homie earlier. She left. I laid down. Now I'm about to shower, shave, and get cute. Bae's getting her hair done, so I'm trying to be up and out of the bathroom before she gets home, so that way she can just hop in and shower and get cute. And we're supposed to be doing drinks and hookah tonight. Most likely get some food Friday night. And then tomorrow we're going to go get her tires done and get that all situated. Normal weekend shenanigans. Y'all already know the tea. We started this yesterday. Yeah, we started the vlog yesterday. So, yeah, because Sunday is probably going to be a chill day. And that'll probably be when y'all get this vlog. But I love y'all. Hope y'all had a good week. Hope y'all ready for the weekend. It's Friday. Thank you, Jesus. Let me go ahead and submit my time sheet and then hop into the shower. I will check in with y'all once we get ready to step out. And of course, I'll show y'all Bae's hair. And we'll just go from there.
Normal weekend shenanigans. As usual. Let's see Bae's hair.
The fresh twist, yeah, feel me. Yeah. Yeah.
You need to come change it. Oh, I'm about to
the bass crack is good.
Crack. It's quack.
I just don't want him to get hit.
Rich nigga. Oh, I'm curious. He got a big figure.
Bitch, you serious?
Ducked out, laid back.
He mysterious.
I'ma make that nigga move. Make him delirious.
In the bed, I'm on the couch, I'm on the floor. I'm a Gemini, baby.
Ain't even never gonna get bored. Y'all, it smells like Fruity Pebbles and cereal. Like, I'm excited as fuck.
Oh, hey, I know I can't taste it, but you might have to order me another thing of bread.
That looks good, babe.
Mm-hmm. Oh, chef, we home, y'all. I am so sorry. I have been a terrible vlogger today. But I just didn't. We weren't really doing nothing exciting. We went to the car wash. We ran some errands. We went out to eat. And now we home. I went and saw my parents. Yeah. Hold on, y'all. Baby work tomorrow, so it'll just be me and you guys. Unless we go walking tomorrow. We try to walk at least once every weekend, primarily on Sunday. What we got in here? Y'all know we had to go somewhere. Hand me the soap.
I'm about to go downstairs.
Okay, you got the laundry and stuff. That's the food. Yeah. Okay. We went to Bath and Well, Bay went to Bath and Body Works and got wildflowers.
Still, y'all, Saturday and Sunday is $3.25.
The wildflowers at Bath and Body Works. We got seafood and cookies. What did we get from Ross? We ain't getting much at Ross. Yeah, it's nothing major. We got like an outfit a piece from Ross since it was right there by Bath and Body Works. And the, what else? I don't know. But Bae got some laundry detergent. And I got some more soap. That's it. Like, yeah. You get my tumbler ahead of the car? Alright. I'll come back on here later, y'all. Hold on. I'm a little tired.
Alright, y'all. We about to chill. I highly doubt that we go out because, like I said earlier, Gina has to work in the morning. So that's why we had kind of went out last night. So it's about to be a movie night. Lay back and kick it. You know, if someone wants to come through and kick back, they can. But we just chilling. And like I said, we probably come back on tomorrow to, you know, close out the vlog or whatever. Gina just put a load of laundry in the washer. She's probably about to get out of the shower and get her clothes together for work in the morning. We, like I said, might go on our little nature walk tomorrow or at least to the park. But other than that, y'all, it was just a normal weekend, real mellow.
Sorry I didn't vlog too much, but I didn't want y'all to get bored. We wasn't really doing nothing major. We were literally running errands, so I didn't want to bore y'all. But I hope y'all having a good weekend and have a great Saturday night, and I'll see y'all tomorrow.
To the store so I can get some dishwashing detergent, and we may go to the park. I don't know, it's kind of cloudy outside, so I don't really know what we're gonna do the rest of the day, but y'all know it's time to get ready for the work week already. The weekend is never long enough, but I hope y'all enjoyed this vlog thus far, and I appreciate y'all just like watching and commenting and fucking with us on social media. Like, we really like doing YouTube. Definitely continue to watch and enjoy and send us suggestions for future videos as we approach the fall season. I think we're gonna try to do Hubert's Farm again. There's the October Harvest Fest that's coming up. And y'all know we doing Miami Round 2. So it's a lot of good stuff coming up. And then of course, y'all know the holiday season is when we kick off Vlogmas. But y'all know we don't do traditional Vlogmas. Like, I don't vlog every day. I still only do the weekends, but who knows, I might throw in some bonus videos this year around. So let me know what content you guys want to see down below, or you guys can hit me up on Instagram or Snapchat. All that information is always listed below, but I figured that I go ahead and show y'all some of my favorite products that I've been using here recently. I haven't done a favorites video in forever, and honestly, I've just been like, I haven't really been wearing makeup. Y'all know I work from home, so Monday through Friday I'm here in my PJs. So on the weekends here recently, I've been trying to like get a little dolled up or whatever, so I figured I'd come on here and kind of show y'all some of my recent favorites and let y'all know what I've been using for my looks and stuff like that. So I'm gonna breeze through it because there's not that many items or whatever, so let's just jump into it. I don't know if y'all remember, but I had hauled this before we went to Miami back in July-ish. Yeah, back in July, I had hauled this, and I've been using it. I really have been using it. Mostly on my face, I use primer and concealer. I don't use foundation. I just don't see the use for it. So I really like this as a primer. It's not over drying, and it doesn't like oil up on me. So this is the Foundation Primer Protect by Laura Mercier. I got this for $10 at Marshall's. So really good tip for me to save money when it comes to makeup or collections that I have missed or products that I have missed. Check your local Marshall's, TJ Maxx, or Ross, because you can find them. And here recently, they've been getting some really good inventory. So I was really happy to find this. I'm hoping I can find a backup to it. But right now, a little bit goes a long way, so you don't need a lot, and I have a full tube, so I'm not tripping, but I definitely want to back up to this because this is my go-to primer right now, and it works amazingly. Like, it doesn't dry out my skin, I don't have breakouts, and it really helps to make my concealer just blend in and look more natural and long-lasting. So yeah, I'd use this, not necessarily like, I thought it would just be good for the summer, but I feel like this would be good, like, universal. Who's writing me? Oh, my sister. My sister's writing me on Facebook. I'm sorry, y'all. But I feel like this would be good universal, like, year-round. Especially if you have, like, combination dry skin. Because I only get oily in the summertime in my T-zone area. And then I get oily around my perimeter of my face and my eyelids. I be dry everywhere else, and then in the winter time I'm primarily only like oily right here in my T-zone area, like literally right in here, and everywhere else will be dry. So I feel like you can get away with combination skin using this primer, but try it out for yourself, especially if you can find it for a cheap price. Okay, so for my highlight, I got this at the cosmetic company. It's from the Teyana Taylor collection. And this is actually the only thing I really wanted from the collection, the House of Petunia. It's a really pretty highlighter, and I love me some Teyana Taylor. So this has been my go-to highlighter to give me that little shimmer, that little glow. And I use this on my shoulder blades and on my face. So It's a really pretty highlighter, and a little bit goes a long way. You don't need a lot. It is gorgeous, y'all. It's gorgeous. I just took a shower. Otherwise, I would swatch it. But I really, if you like Gold Deposit, you're going to like this. It's just not as bronzy as Gold Deposit. It's a lot more warm and goldy, which I like on my warm golden tones. So, yeah. That's my go-to highlighter. Y'all know for my all-over face, I've just been using my Mineralize Skin Finish in Deepest Dark. That's my go-to for that. For blush, I got this from Ross. This is the Laura Geller Hollywood Blushing Baked Blush Duo. This is like my bronzer blush combo palette so that I don't have to put too much product on my face. I use this for blush and bronzer, and I use Pink Grapefruit the most. I go between Pink Grapefruit and Bora Bora. I don't really use Honeysuckle, but I use these two the most right here. And it's just like my go-to bronzer blush palette right now. And it's so compact, it's so easy to travel with, and I got it from Ross for, how much I pay for this? $6. So yeah, I've been using the hell out of that as well. And then to set everything, I've been using this travel size matte finish, Fenty Matte Long Lasting Makeup Setting Spray from NYX. I got this from Target. You can get the full size elsewhere, Ulta, NYX.com. And they probably even have it at Target, but this is travel friendly. I'll probably get the full size for home and get me another one of these for travel purposes. But this is what's been helping my makeup last when I'm in like hot ass surroundings, club, outside, especially here in the humid season. Definitely like this so that my makeup is not too dewy and like my natural oils can kind of come through a little bit. But this helps for, you know, eyeshadow looks. It keeps my eyelids from getting super oily to where my eyeshadow may slid or anything like that. To prevent that, I've been using the hell out of this. And I also use this to dampen my Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. So yeah, really, really like this. And yeah, this is like a holy grail for some people. This is an oldie but goodie. And then beauty supply store wise, I miss these, y'all. The Cherry Blossom. Don't get me wrong, I love my dramatic big lashes. Those are my go-to when I'm trying to look really, you know, shaboom, boom, boom. But sometimes I just want to have a natural flare type of lash. And Cherry Blossom never disappoints, and they're 99 cents at my local beauty supply store. So your girl racked up. Like, I racked up. So these are some of my favorites. The 911s. The 916s. I got two pairs of those. And y'all, I've been to beauty supply store twice, so this was not an all one trip. These are some of my favorites, the 917s. I had these on last night. These are the night before. The 918s. The 924s. The 937s, and I got two of these. These are my ultimate favorite, the 937s. So yeah, those are my favorite Cherry Blossom lashes, and like they're 99 cent lashes. Like 99 cent, you can't beat that. Period. So yeah, y'all, these have been my like go-to. These are lashes that you can wear on a daily, and they're not overly dramatic. And the big ones tend to overshadow your makeup sometimes because everyone's so focused on how big your fucking lashes are. These are way more natural, and you can get away with a really great eyeshadow look with these. So yeah, really love my Cherry Blossom lashes, always have. And lastly, my go-to everyday glossy lip glosses. These are by Magic Collection, and these are my two. They stay in my purse. This is Juicy Jelly. It's supposed to be flavored, but don't eat it. This is in mango, I think. And these are like $1.99. And this one is watermelon, the one I got on my lips now. I love these. These are great stocking stuffers. These are great glosses for like preteens. These are great glosses because they don't make you look too grown, and they're good and moisturizing. So, yeah. And that's it. that is pretty much all that I've been rocking. Y'all see my new bag. I love my new Aldo bucket bag. Y'all, this is my baby. This is as close as I'm gonna get to a designer bucket bag for right now. But I just think that Aldo bags, they are more expensive than Forever 21, but they're worth it because they're really good quality. They give you that luxury designer look without the huge price. So I love my new bag. So yeah, that is all I wanted to talk to you guys about and share with y'all. If we do anything else exciting, y'all know I'll come back and share it with y'all and end out the vlog. But I'm just waiting for babe to get back. So I'll see y'all later.
You know, we kind of talked about this earlier in terms of following your heart and going, you know, with your intuition. With the judgment being in reverse also, I feel like you changed your mind about something and it ended up working out for your greater benefit, all right? Yeah. With the Sun card, with the Page of Pentacles, I feel like there's a lot of different options that you're reviewing, you're doing research. If you buy something and you need to take it back to the store. Like, don't be upset about that, because I feel like
we the fam, that's what they call me. I promise that you never be lonely.